Yes, the one and only Nelly last night dancing with the stars. He's our first guest. The backflip that made everybody flip out. And Nelly is standing by in LA for it's early there. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
I had to rush right in because I didn't want to waste any time. How did it feel last night for you?
Last night was great. You know, it was Disney night, so you know, they brought out all the theatrics and the costumes, and everybody was dressed up looking like a big Halloween fest, so to speak.
You know? Okay, I'm sorry. Nelly, I have to be honest. Your teeth are beautiful. I mean, like, your teeth are stunning. It's live TV, and I'm tired, too, because I stayed up watching you, so I have no filter at this hour.
Thank you.
I mean, I have to tell you, a lot of people are like, oh, my gosh, Nelly is so good on the show. And I'm like, don't you know country? This is Nelly. You have surprised people. I know they knew you could rap and all the music talents, but you're keeping up with the dancing.
Yeah, I have a great teacher. I have a great teacher. Danny's she's special. She's went through a lot to get me to to find the correct steps, and probably a lot of bumps and bruises on her shins and on her feet. But yeah, she's dope. You know, we've been rehearsing my butt off.
You have been. Tell me, what made you decide to do this show? I know you've got some new music coming out. We're going to talk about that. But why'd you do the show?
You know, I think it was more or less. Actually, it came more so as a dare, just because, you know, I talk a lot of smack about me being able to do a lot of different things. And this kind of came across the table, this amongst some other shows. And a lot of other shows I felt like I didn't really want to do because some of them was musical. And I was like, I wouldn't know how to be in a musical competition considering that's what I do. And I thought that this would challenge me a little more and this would make me work harder. And this would, you know, give us something to do during the pandemic times.
I love it. I love it. So, obviously, we've been fans of yours since forever. And I remember when my team told me you were going to be able to join us this morning, thinking about when you brought your daughter, Chanel, on the red carpet. I think it was 2009. She was 15. Yeah. She's now 26. And she's got her own music career.
Yeah, yeah. Amongst other things, she's like her daddy. She's all over the place. So, but yeah, she's a big girl now. She works on her music, and she has a radio show up and coming real soon as well that she's getting ready to do. So yeah,
that's crazy. She is the age you were when Country Grammar became a multi-platinum album. So she's about your age. Do you offer her any
close
advice?
I think she's like a year older than I was. Around the same time.
Well, you also have your son, Cornell. And you've been open over the years about raising your sister's children. You lost your sister. And you shared with that public pain of losing her. Was it 2005?
Yes, ma'am.
What has that been like? That's so sweet you call me ma'am. What has that been like raising her children and sharing that love that you both shared?
Well, you know, definitely I wouldn't be anything without the help of her mother and family members, my brother and all, even though I possibly bear the financial part of it and a lot of the discipline part when it had to come down to it. But I definitely had to have help. And it was just one of those situations where it was a no-brainer. That's what you do. That's what family's there for. You know, we pick up the pieces and we mold each other and we help shape each other. But those kids helped raise me as much as I helped raise them because, you know, I don't know where I would be possibly without them, without their genuine, just that genuine spirit of just having that love around. So, you know, it works.
And now you're working on your first country album, Heartland. You are dipping into all these territories that are new to you.
Yeah, well, I don't call it a country album. I call it country influence.
Okay.
I say it's country influence even because I definitely want to respect all those whose country is their field and this is what they do.
Yeah.
So I just don't think that Nelly's going to wake up one day and make a country album, even though the country community has embraced me so much, like what you said, all over the years, even starting with the Tim McGraw, when a lot of people thought I was crazy when I said that that's what I wanted to do. And even moving on with FGL and Cruz and like you said, Kane Brown and Jimmy Allen and a host of other people that I've been very, very fortunate to work with in that field. But I think it's one of those albums where I have so much love in that field that I'm doing something from my heart that we call From the Heartland. And it's basically, it's country influence, though. I like to say that because it's definitely still Nelly.